Hello everyone and welcome to another Warcraft 3 replay commentary. Today we are going to watch a game played in November of 2005 in the Inn Cup on Twisted Meadows. As you can see, it is an Orc against Undead matchup, and spawning here in the top left corner in orange is the Danish Orc player Roel. He starts with an altar first, and his second building is obviously going to be the Orc Burrow, and his opponent on the top right spawn position in red is the German Undead player Exlord. At that time, still really young, I think he must have been like 14 or 15 around the time this game was played, so he was still an upcoming player. As we can see, he starts with Crypt, Ziggurat and a delayed altar, so we're most likely going to see a couple of ghouls together with a late Death Knight early on. And as you can see, Roel is already queuing up three more peons in his Great Hall. So this means he's not going to add a barracks before starting his tier 2 tech. So he's only going to have an altar and an Orc Burrow once he starts taking two tier 2. So we're most likely going to see a Farseer first here. Yeah, that's the case. And since he's not going to have any supporting units for that one early on, we're most likely not going to see him creeping, because that wouldn't be efficient at all, and he's going to try to harass as good as possible. Whereas, as we can see, Exlord is already delaying his heroes, his hero to have some more ghouls early on, so his investment into those units probably is going to mean he's going to want to get ahead experience-wise early on while trying to keep up tech-wise as good as possible. So Roel can now start his tech. Exord is scouting that with his Acolyte. Farseer is about to come out, and a very early war mill for Roel. So usually the first two buildings you would want to get in this case is the barracks and the second burrow, just to have the two grunts out as soon as you hit tier 2. So this very early war mill is kind of interesting, so this might mean that he's up to something special on tier 2, which needs a lot of lumber. So I'm not really sure what to interpret into this very early war mill, but we are going to see what playstyle he's going to choose to go for on tier 2. And it looks like this Acolyte scout timing didn't quite tell Roel where his opponent is. So he's scouting down here with the wolf, and he sees there is no blight there. Already turning around, going into the bottom right corner with his Farseer. So it seems like he sort of even excluded the top right spawn position due to the timing of that scout Acolyte. So this gives Exlord some time to start creeping. He's gonna get a bit of experience on his Death Knight. I mean, this tiny green camp is most likely not gonna be game deciding, but it's a little bonus. The Farseer is now going to come in from the bottom. The Nerubian Tower timing here is very well for Exlord, and really plays into his favor here. He can even delay this wolf from getting through the gap with his ghoul, even though I think that was not intentionally. Oops, creep camp already has finished. The Death Knight actually is not coiling this Acolyte here. He's trying to block the Farseer in, but not successfully. And now he's out of tower range. So this means the Farseer is going to survive for now. And he did get one Acolyte killed, which isn't too bad. We see the tech of... sorry. We see the tech of Exlord is a little bit more than halfway done, so this is going to cost him quite some gold. And as I mentioned early on, he doesn't really have Roel doesn't really have anything besides this Farseer, and that means getting an Acolyte killed here for free early on isn't too bad of a start after all. Exlord now moving out with just his skeletons and two ghouls, gonna continue creeping. He's gonna get the level 2 here if he doesn't abandon this creep camp, which I think he's not going to, because his tech is almost done. And even though, even if he would lose another Acolyte here, wouldn't be too big of a deal, since actually he is gonna lose another Acolyte, since his tech is going to be is going to be finished right now, and he can just reproduce that. Obviously, it's a free kill for Roll, so that's not too bad as well. But having that level 2 is probably worth the trade. So we do see a TC second, 1B3, and a very quick tier 3 tech. So that is not that expected, I'd say. Maybe let's just take a look at what Xlord is doing here first. He's gonna be too late to cancel this B3. He only has 2 ghouls and his Death Knight, so there's really nothing he can do to threaten the Orc's main base here. And Roll, is he... He's actually walking back. I feel like he should just start creeping here, because, as I mentioned, Xlord cannot do anything against the main of his opponent. And therefore, chasing after this Death Knight and 2 ghouls might be a bit of wasted opportunity for Roll, but maybe that's just what Xlord wants here. Xlord in the meantime also starting his tier 3 tech. So the reason why this is strange is, let's see, he's getting a raider first. The reason why this is strange is that there were 2 ways back then to really play as Orc against Undead in those games, and that would either be Grunt's Raiders and staying tier 2 and getting really aggressive all the time. It was kind of the no-brainer playstyle, or to go Windriders, but then he would need double B3, so going for such a quick tier 3 tech while still being on only 1 B3 seems kind of odd to me. So Ensnare is being researched just now. One Raid is already with the army, but he's not going to get the Ensnare for now. Surround attempt, the Death Knight barely gets out. And if he doesn't turn around, he should be able to get away, because there is no Endurance Aura thus far. And therefore, the Death Knight is going to be able to outrun this Raider. Okay, there's the second B3. And, okay, there's a Windrider coming already. I was about to mention that he's going for Stomp here. And if he did go for Grunt's Raiders, he would go for Shockwave, because then he would have to rely on Chainwave for his damage output. And if he's going Stomp, that's just kind of a supporting spell. And he needs something else for the really big damage output. And therefore, having that Stomp skilled instead of Wave kind of tells that it's not going to be pure Grunt's Raiders. So, Dreadlord for Xlord. And the first sleep already occurred on the TC here, but Roll was able to block him out. Now he's going to be able to close the surround. TP is on the far side. It looks like he's trying to pass it, but no, he didn't get it. He still has the TP. And very good surround here by Xlord, given the fact that his Dreadlord was out of mana already. And therefore, he didn't have any more sleep available. And that means he had to close the surround without casting another sleep. And he did so successfully. And having this Dreadlord second back then, also a more popular choice, obviously, than nowadays. I mean, no one's playing Dreadlord second nowadays against against Orc anymore. They are the first 2 Windriders out. Let's see how well prepared he is. Maybe should upgrade this tower here, but maybe he's not 100% sure of Xlord going Windriders already. But then again, he has already added a second crypt, so this kind of tells that he has some sort of a clue about that. So what was I saying? Oh yeah, the Dreadlord second. Of course, since he's not going Fiends, and since this is the pre-Fiend era, at least as the main component of the Undead's army, the Frost Armor was not at all used, and having this Dreadlord is kind of nice against the Grunt's Raiders, because with the number of ghouls Xlord invested in here, he's going to be able to very easily get all those surrounds and just stop his opponent from getting aggressive for quite a while. And that's not at all what you want with Grunt's Raiders. And of course, in these, what we're maybe gonna see is some gargoyles here, and in those gargoyles, ghouls fights against this these Orc air armies, which also happened a lot back then, which Fof was kind of perfect in doing. The Aura, of course, is a huge supporter as well, so he's got the orb already Rebuilding one Acolyte. I'm assuming he's gonna upgrade a Spirit Tower here soon, so this is gonna shut this harassment down in a little while. Meanwhile, some more creeping has been done by the Orc player. Two rings of protection for him in the meantime, so I'm assuming he's gonna wanna sell these soon. And he's adding, oh, okay, miss movement here, gonna lose a grunt. He's adding more and more Wind Riders. So that's really gonna be the army he's gonna rely on here. And we're actually not going to see these gargoyle shenanigans. We're gonna see fiends. Exort is adding web, is adding fiends. Let's see what items he's going to get here. At the same time, as I mentioned earlier, this Dreadlord kind of shuts down any attempts from Roll to get aggressive too early on. He's gonna wanna get a bigger army, make the sleep plus surround less of a threat just by having more damage output against these ghouls, because obviously with a stomp and a couple of Wind Riders, okay, so this is gonna shut this harassment down right now, with stomp and a couple of Wind Riders, his focus fire against the ghouls is gonna be really incredibly high. So yeah, one Wind Rider is going down, the rest of the army is heading back towards the Orc base, level 3 for this Dreadlord. Actually, he does have the Bone Chimes, he did get the Vampiric Aura. Must have been here when he crept this early, that's... Or maybe here. Let's just see what else he got. So, no, that was definitely here. So otherwise, if he had found it here, he already have sold it, because there's no point in obviously having it twice. And I don't think that he's gonna wanna get two spells on his Dreadlord, because I don't think he's gonna be able to support that mana wise. So very passive mid game here by both the players, both of them trying to sort of get the right army to fight later on. I mean, with this number of Wind Riders, he's already going to pose a major threat to all of those ghouls. So Exort is gonna have to bring a couple of fiends into the mix as well, which he already is doing. He's actually got those burrowed here behind his gold mine, so he kind of set up this trap for the Wind Riders when they fly in and harass. But Roll seems like is not going to go for that kind of style here anymore. He did quite some damage. Right now he is falling back. We do see 49 supply against 60. So Exort is a little bit behind in that aspect. And Orb of Darkness. Actually, it might not be too bad here, just due to the fact that he's gonna be able to attack the Wind Riders. And he's gonna creep the island, so he's most likely going to go for an expansion, and obviously with Exlord investing into mass ghouls, it's gonna be really hard for him to do anything against that. We're under attack. So with the tier 3, obviously he can just get a tiny Great Hall and get that expansion going really, really quickly. Plus he might get a nice item here, Wind of Mana Stealing in the meantime for the Dreadlord. Got a close of attack. Yeah, the items are kind of okay-ish. I'm really curious to see when he's gonna get level 4, if he's gonna skill the aura on level 2, or if he's actually gonna go for the Carrion Swarm, or the Speed Home even, and the Robe of the Magi plus 6, so very good items here for the undead player. So let's see, he still hasn't skilled anything thus far. TC is going to the shop, and yeah, he's getting the tiny Great Hall, so that's not extremely surprising at this stage of the game. Still both the players very, very passively walking around the map, just creeping up their heroes, and the Vampiric Aura has been skilled to level 2. He passed the Scourge Bone Chimes to his Death Knight, and I'm assuming he's gonna sell them sooner or later. So this expansion sort of may indicate that Roll is not going to go into a fight too early in the next couple of minutes. Axelot, by the way, saved up a lot of gold here, staying on 50 supply for a very long time. Of course, he's not gonna wanna fight without his fiends there. So in case he would get creep checked, right now he would just have to use his town portal, just because A, he didn't break into low upkeep so far. He doesn't have his entire army with him. And yeah, that would just mean, oh, that's a very nice item. That would just mean, yeah, obviously in a fight, he would not look good right now. So it looks like Roel isn't even going to go ahead and creep. He wants to immediately, as it appears, take advantage of his resource advantage, of his income advantage. So he's at 66 supply. Axelot still not going into low upkeep. But I'm assuming he's just gonna trade TPs here. Yeah, he's just trading TPs. So of course he's not gonna wanna fight a big ghoul fiend army inside his opponent's main base, where there is three towers and the shooting main. And as I mentioned, he's just taking advantage of his higher income right now, since he's getting like around 14 gold a second, whereas Axelot only gets 10. Stand ready. And Axelot also not expanding so far. So you might think that he'd want to add a Lich third, or he should already have added a Lich third by now. I feel like at this stage of the game it's really difficult though, because the Orc heroes are decently leveled, but the focus fire with these Windriders is really incredible. So if he gets Ensnare on the Lich, if he gets Stomp on the DK, and he does like two waves of shots with these Windriders, a level 1 Lich would immediately go down. So it's really, yeah, really not that clear to me if getting a Lich 3rd at this stage of the game would still be a wise decision, or if it would just be feeding Roel at this point. So he's just gonna continue creeping Death Knight and Dreadlord do not see this army, as it seems. And he just wants to get level 5 on both of his heroes. He can just quickly take down this Gnoll Overseer, take the item and run back. Obviously, oops, obviously if he gets creep checked here, that would be pretty bad for him. That would just probably cost him a TP. I think he just misclicked and caught the Skeleton instead of the Gnoll Overseer. But yeah, it didn't matter in the end, obviously. So both the Orc heroes are level 4 by now, both the Undead heroes are level 5. And there's the counter expansion for Axelot. Let's just see. He did not see this so far. He revealed all the islands earlier on, as you can see on the minimap. But yeah, that was prior to this expansion being built by Roel. And it looks like right now Axelot has broken into upkeep. He's at 60 supply. And he's finally collecting his entire army to get into a fight. That's actually a pretty huge army. That's kind of the strength of these ghouls, fiends, armies. If the opponent is in a bad position and is really caught off guard, you can do such a lot of damage, and you can take out so many of those fragile Windriders in a very, very short time. So he's probably gonna, okay, he didn't even start building that expansion so far, so he's not gonna cancel that. Let's see if he's gonna see the Acolyte. Well, actually he did, but he turned around anyway. So maybe didn't pay attention to the minimap. It looks like Axelot might be willing to get aggressive here and yeah, buy some time, distract Roel while getting this expansion into production. So he starts chopping down the swarm mill. One defense upgrade is done here, and actually with those three towers, yeah, he's gonna have a huge support in defending against those ghouls. I mean, as I mentioned earlier with the Windriders, the focus fire is incredibly good against ghouls. Obviously, so is the focus fire of towers and burrows. But 0-1 upgrades for Roel only, and inferior hero levels compared to 2-2 ghouls, plus frenzy, obviously, for Axelot. And he's going to be the one TPing right now, so those guys, they will exchange TPs. Let's see if either of the players is going to be able to take anything down. Only the one Rubin Tower falls. So once again, TPs exchanged. He once again made use of his income advantage. Still up by only 10 supply, if you want to call it that, having that great haul in production. And also, I mean, he's got more workers here, definitely. So army-wise, they're not that far apart. And Exelot has superior upgrades, so I'm not 100% sure where all the income has gone for Roel.
Our gold mine is nearly empty.
Yeah, so he seems to be really scared of fighting right now. Okay, an Exelot bringing an Acolyte to the top here, and there's the expansion going to be produced. Maybe not the most expected position from Roel's point of view. Who's gonna lose his barracks now as well, which isn't gonna be a big deal. I mean, he doesn't want to build grunts at this point anyway. And Exelot is really seems to have trouble getting into a good fighting position. And it looks like he's actually gonna go ahead and fight those towers. I mean, with the ghouls, he's gonna be able to take down the towers really quickly. But he's not getting the chance to focus these. Scroll of Protection used. Windrider is in a pretty decent position. Actually, Stomp is stunning a lot of stuff here. TC slept, but the Death Knight has been focused down, and he had the TP, so that is a very big deal, as this fight actually started out pretty good for Exelot in my opinion, but the Death Knight going down here is a really, really big deal, and yeah, even though the Death Knight is down, all these Windriders are webbed in a horrible position, and we're gonna see the supply totally dwindling here for Roel. Level 6 for the Dreadlord here, getting the Infernal into play for the first time in this game after a bit more than 20 minutes played. And yeah, that Infernal is going to get focused down here, as it seems, but not after not before Exelot hasn't taken down all of the Windriders. So we do see a couple of fiends remaining here, and I don't really think it's smart by Exelot to stay in this fight for now. I mean, let's just see, there is no dust for his opponent, but taking down these towers with the fiends like he does right now, even losing one more here, taking down those towers with the fiends is not really efficient for him. So with only the two heroes and those towers, Roel is able to deflect Exelot's push, at least for now, at least until the Death Knight is back. And this Dreadlord is already approaching level 7. And Exelot, yeah, he's making very good use of the fact that there is no dust here for his opponent. Even webbing another Windrider. And just continuously sleeping this TC. And you can really see that panel of mana here at work. Almost 800 mana available on this... he actually uses the Fiend here. On this Dreadlord, who by now has reached level 7. So Exelot at the moment with the unit advantage, but just those two heroes are such a big deal, so difficult to deal with for him right now. Death Knight is back. The statue is... Okay, he actually stops moving, so yeah, the statue is definitely going to fall. And TP out by Roel. I feel like he could have just walked to the bottom. So the expansion is up. Roel might be aware of it because he just saw the Acolytes moving towards the top of the map. But at the same time, obviously Roel having that second expansion already up is going to keep him in the income advantage. Exelot also has not scouted this so far. And neither this one. So he probably should have an idea, but no confirmation thus far. And he just keeps the pressure up. Just see, where are those guys going? Another expansion probably, and there's the ghoul scouting the expansion, and there is no tower whatsoever there, so the ghoul might be able to do quite some damage.
Ready to ride.
Let's just see, where is the orc army?
Ready to ride.
At the island for some reason. But he's gonna have to come back and defend here. And if he does so, I don't really see Exelot being too successful with this push, since there's tons of burrows he's gonna fight against. There's the tower. He's got some ensnares. He's got some Windriders again. Not really sure why he's investing into more raiders right now. I feel like having 3 raiders is okay since they're only the supporting unit and they do summon snares, but they don't really do the damage. So I feel like if you have an army of that size, you'd rather want to get more damage output than more ensnares. Okay, now he got it. Alright, that's of course a way to save Europeans. Just have them build towers and be protected while doing so. It looks like X-Lord is gonna head down there right now to try and stop these towers from going up.
We're under attack.
But of course, Roel, being aware of that, is heading down there right now as well. There's a second expansion from X-Lord coming, which we saw earlier, and actually the wolves are scouting the wrong position here. Another Infernal is being casted here. Two of the towers have already been cancelled. Looks like the Infernal is going to be focused down first. But Coil, of course, is a really big deal for that, is able to heal 600 hit points here. And he's doing a lot of damage with the Immolation on the Infernal and also able to put it back in snare, has worn off. But the towers have come up, so that's really gonna help Roel once again. And now he's gonna be able to take down this Infernal. He's gonna lose his first Raider here in return. Or actually, the Windrider is the first unit going down. The Storm hitting really good here, both the heroes and one of the Fiends. The Fiend is being coiled here in time. One of the Raiders now finally going down. And Burrow used, but Chain Lightning hitting just in time. Still no Dust for the Orc player though. So that could really backfire on him here. Pretty nice Stomp. Death Knight is gonna be forced to TP. I don't really see a way around that happening. And another Fiend is going to fall in the process, as well as another Raider. But Roel has secured his second expansion here for now. Both his heroes barely over level 5 though. Death Knight 5.5, so this Dreadlord is by far the most experienced hero on the field, being level 7.5 already. And okay, those towers are too late, and I'm assuming X-Lord is probably gonna wanna TP in here. He's got 2 charges of the Rod of Necromancy. He's not okay. He did cancel one of these towers, but not the second one. And there's the TP coming in. The army size for Roel isn't really impressive though. But neither is X-Lord's very good stomp here, hitting pretty much everything. First Fiend is going down. The Windrider is in a good position. Actually, I feel like he should walk around and get those killed first. He decides to take down the Raider first. Now he's going for those Windriders. First Zetu is going to fall in the meantime as well. Both these low HP Windriders will be taken out. Another Fiend going down. So both the players really relying on their heroes here, doing a lot of damage. Meanwhile, this Dreadlord, who's, as I mentioned earlier, on almost 800 mana, is really, really making good use of that sleep. And actually, Roel should try and wake his TC here, because he's just sleeping all the time. But once again, no dust, by the way, so that really, really backfires on Roel. Once again, X-Lord barely saving this Fiend here. But with two more Fiends coming in, he might just be able to deflect this push. Another Coil hitting one of the Fiends. Still plenty of mana on the Death Knight, which is kind of surprising, since he's been throwing these Coils over and over and over again. Once again, perfectly timed Coil. The Ensnare is probably not going to wear off. So finally, this Fiend is going down. But except for the one Raider and the two heroes, there's nothing left for Roel in this fight. So he's going to have to pull back. It looks like X-Lord might try to go for the surround here. But I don't think he's going to get it. The three Fiends unboarded are supporting his damage output a little bit here. But micro not quite perfectly, so he's gonna lose another Fiend here, level 6 for the Death Knight in the return though. And let's see, does he have a TP? There is a TP here, so he needs to pass that. I think the TC is pretty safely surrounded. Stomp is gonna get him out of that surround. The Death Knight did have the mana, but he wasn't able to coil a Fiend here in time. And now with the Infernal, he's again closing the surround, and the TC goes down just before the TP has gone through. Level 8 for the Dreadlord here, not even half an hour played. And X-Lord for now has secured his expansion. He lost a lot of stuff. He's down to 33 supply. He's got those two mines running finally. More or less. Okay, actually, it seems like he didn't reproduce here early on. So during this entire fight, which lasted really long, he had the inferior income. And actually, you can see that. Wow, Roel saved up a lot of gold. staying under 50 supply all the time. TC, okay, has been rebought at the tavern. He saved up a lot of gold, and he's going to be able to reinforce his army with a lot of Windriders very quickly. I don't really see a reason not to break upkeep right now and try and do some damage to Exord before he can heavily secure this expansion. Just see, Roll has not scouted this, so this is kind of strange to me. He saw these Acolytes moving up there earlier on, and he should be aware of the fact that there is another expansion here. And it looks like Roll is actually not going to defend this expansion.
Our town is under attack.
I mean, he's taking down all the Acolytes here with the wolves. So I don't really see him. Like, right now this is more or less empty, so I don't really see him see a point in him running into those towers right now. I feel like he should rather defend. And actually, it looks like he's going to do so. And just looking at the supply kind of tells you everything you need to know in this fight. There's no way Exlord can come out on top here. Bring all the fiends. And even with the Infernal, he's focusing the Infernal first again, which is seems kind of strange to me because it's so tanky and it can be healed. First Raider is going down, Chain Lightning is going through. And actually Exlord is kinda doing better than I would have expected. But yeah, the focus fire against those fiends is pretty incredible. There's only the two heroes left right now and one fiend on the field. And level 6 for Death Knight and Farseer, so all the heroes are now level 6 or higher. One fiend unburrowed and the Death Knight. Actually, since there's no raider remaining, he can just walk out, but right now the Dreadlord might get into some trouble. Stomp also killing the burrowed fiend here. So I guess that was not intentionally. But still, Stomp, yeah, securing him two fiend kills here. And actually, I think the trade went a tiny bit better for Roll, but it went a lot better for Exlord than I expected. So I would have assumed Exlord would TP out immediately once the Orc army came in there. So I'm curious to see if he did have Earthquake right now. I think he could make use of that. Cast it like in here, like on those four buildings.
Upgrade complete.
So Exlord once again really, really, really down supply wise. But he's definitely got the superior heroes at this stage of the game. So once again he is TPing in. Obviously he needs to defend this expansion. And I mean, with those four towers, I do not think he's gonna have a problem defending that. No, pretty nice Chain Lightning actually killing three Acolytes here. Once again, completely erasing the income of this expansion. So this one has been so expensive for Exlord actually. Like, during all this time, this expansion has been running completely safely and steadily, but this one has cost him so much, these towers, he lost so many Acolytes, and we can clearly see that in both the player's supply, while Roll had two running mines, which were completely safe, actually getting a third one right now, two running mines from which he totally benefited from all the time, and Exlord only had one. Like, this doesn't really count. I mean, this is... yeah, this is an expansion, but it's cost him more than it really brought him.
Summoning is complete.
Also nice to see how both the players just occasionally take those breaks and start chatting. I mean, this was the in-cup in late 05, and there were players like... that's unfortunate. There were players like Grubby and Lin usually winning, and the X-Lords and Rolls obviously then didn't have a serious shot at actually winning some money, so it was just a little bit more casual for them participating in those cups. And third expansion also for Exlord. Oh, and that's probably not a fight he wants to take without these towers. So Ensnare on the Dreadlord, very early coil here. The Infernal actually pretty well placed, a lot of stuff has been stunned here. Death Knight, oh, very nicely pulled back here to dodge the stomp and then to be able to coil the Dreadlord in time, but still he needs to pull back. Next stomp doing a bit of damage on the Death Knight and securing another Fiend kill for Roll, even another Fiend kill, and the Dreadlord, oh, that was a mistake. I think he just wanted to pass the heal potion, but the stomp stunned him with perfect timing, and therefore the level 8 Dreadlord's going down, level 7 for the Death Knight in the meantime, but Exarch just lost pretty much everything except the Death Knight in this Infernal, and he once again is gonna have to pull back into his towers. The Death Knight, there is a stomp available, and the TC obviously can go down at this point, he doesn't really bother, but yeah, he needs to be taken down just to buy the Death Knight this time to get back to his towers. And let's see. Yeah, the Farseer is out of mana, so he does he would have two ensnares and a bit of damage output from those fiends, but since the Death Knight still has the potion, I think it would be quite suicidal to charge in there after him. So instead he's gonna go for this expansion, as it seems, and that one is definitely going to suffer. I don't see this one surviving this push. I mean, there's only the Death Knight to defend at this point. X-Lords, yeah, Dreadlord is halfway back. He's adding more ghouls and fiends. I'm really wondering at this, at the tech choice by both the players. I mean, this game is just both the players getting ghouls, fiends against raiders, windriders, and just going at it all the time. Actually, the Infernal doing a bit of damage here, but it's gonna pay for it, and it's gonna feed the roll some more experience. Level 7 for the Farseer, almost level 7 for the TC. I mean, X-Lord doesn't really have a lot of opportunities here. Going for Destroyers or Frostworms would be really stupid against against the Windriders, because unless you have a bunch of newly morphed Destroyers with full mana, there's no way Destroyers are gonna beat Windriders. And for Roll, I think he might not. Yeah, maybe a Torrent Switch wouldn't be too bad, because obviously there's only ground for X-Lord. But then again, if you would go Torrents, the heavy air units would become more of a viable option. He's actually, he's investing a lot into these raiders. Once again, I feel like if he wants to fight straight up, 5 raiders is just too much. He could have like 3 raiders and more windriders instead, because those are the damage dealers. The raiders are just supporting. So the Infernal is not going to secure the surround on the TC, but he gets the surround on the Farseer, and actually the TP is on the TC as well as the heal potion. So he's gonna have to try and somehow pass something to the Farseer, but he is slapped, immediately woken up this time though. But it looks like the Farseer is gonna fall eventually. Very, very little damage output remaining. The Death Knight is also in trouble. The Farseer force stomp comes a brief moment after the TP. So that was a very close save on this Death Knight. And Dreadlord level 9 in the meantime. And even though he killed this Farseer, that was really expensive. Look at these ghoul corpses. So yeah, the wolves are not going to take down this Death Knight. Just see, he does have aura level 3. I'm wondering if he has Death Pact or the ultimate. We're under attack. So once again, Farseer rebuild. Obviously those tavern revives of heroes in that high levels is insanely expensive. So the island expansion has of course run out. I mean, it's only 10,000, I think. Yeah, it's only 10,000. So that's kind of the weakness of these island expansions, that they don't really have a lot of gold inside of them. So there's 2 running expansions. Sorry. There's 2 running expansions for the Orc player, who as I mentioned, it's really that was really casual here, just pointing out how many expansions you have to your opponent. There's 2 running expansions against still 3. I think this one isn't gonna last too much longer. Actually, still, yeah, more than 2,500. So two running expansions against two running expansions, with a third one in production for X-Lord, who's right now trying to... Is he trying to hide his Ecolites? No, he's trying to get them back into safety, but that might be just the wrong choice. Of course he didn't know the Orc army was there. And Roll, is he actually gonna start this fight without his Windrider sword? Okay, now they are coming in from the bottom, but still TP occurs. I'm not sure if that was entirely necessary. I mean, X-Lord has been down supply-wise for basically the entire game. That seemed a little bit overly cautious here by the Orc player. I think he could have stayed in there a bit longer. Okay, the Farseer was out of mana. So, that may have been an issue. But yeah, he's up by 30 supply. Maybe he just didn't want to take the risk. Because, of course, in the beginning of this fight, he was kind of getting his raiders trapped against all these ghouls, and the Windriders were just coming in from the bottom. So maybe he felt like the start of this fight wasn't really going the way he wanted it to. And I'm wondering, is this the first time he scouts this expansion? It might be. It's also strange that he still has only 0-1 upgrades, especially with that many Windriders. Like an attack upgrade or two really, really makes a huge difference. I mean, I guess not against the ghouls, but against the fiends and the heroes, because one volley of all those guys is gonna take down a ghoul anyway. And is he actually gonna go ahead and attack here? I feel like going down to those two expansions would make more sense in attacking them, because this one isn't gonna last for a very long time anymore anyway. But he did a good job, he killed all the Ecolites, and there's no Necropolis here, so resaturating that one is gonna take a really, really long time for X-Lord, and it's gonna be really annoying, and it's gonna limit his income by a lot. It looks like X-Lord actually... Yeah, I was just wondering for a second, is he actually gonna try and get aggressive here? Because what X-Lord been doing for the past 20 minutes is to just try and hold on to his own expansions, let alone getting aggressive here. And yeah, right now it seems like it's gonna be Roll who's gonna be willing to fight. He's even breaking into high upkeep, being at 84 supply right now. Not really any protective items on his heroes. And it actually is X-Lord who's gonna try and get aggressive here. In the meantime, the wolves are raging quite a bit, but he's gonna have to resummon them. That's really funny. Using the earthquake here just to secure this position. I mean, yeah, he's not gonna wanna fight here anymore, but it's just to defend those two burrows. Seems kind of useless to me. X-Lord just pulling back here for a little bit. Infernal used once again. And as you can see, the focus fire on those ghouls is quite insane. Chain Lightning used as well. The next Stomp should be doing really well. Ultimate used by the Death Knight now as well. So a ton of ultimates here in this fight. And actually, it seems like Roll doesn't want to fight without his base supporting him here. That's gonna cost him 3 more Windriders just by repositioning. I'm not really sure if that was completely necessary, but the ultimate in this case actually adds a lot of damage out with those ghouls, who are doing extremely well against the raiders as well as in supporting the rest of the army against the Windriders. It looks like he's just gonna go for the raider. But if Roll pays attention, I think that one should survive. Yeah, ultimate is over right now. And once again, the fights are going really well for X-Lord, at least for the most part. Death Knight approaching level 8 already. Getting one heal scroll here, two heal scrolls. And yeah, X-Lord, supply-wise, he's getting closer and closer. So still having those two tech ghouls, now adding some abominations. I feel like, yeah, at this stage of the game, I'm not really a huge fan of having those ghouls as part of the army anymore. I mean, even though they're doing really, really great against raiders, especially with those upgrades, I feel like they're just so vulnerable against the Windrider Focus and the Chain Lightning and the Stomp that the abominations just seem to make a lot more sense to me at this point. Let's just see, this one is soon gonna run out. Another expansion here by Roll on the bottom. So basically the player's just taking the entire map here. This one is gonna run out in just a couple of seconds.
The dam stand ready.
Yes. And what did Roll get? Invoke potion on the TC. Not really a great fan of his items here. And he just continues sending those wolves. But he's not doing an insane amount of damage anymore, just thanks to the fact that there are four towers here. And is he? It looks like he's gonna continue to do some creeping, of course. Not at all a bad choice, since Exod isn't really doing anything. And he definitely can use all the gold he can get right now, and this item obviously is very good for him. And maybe he's even gonna want to take another island expansion, because that is a freaking scary army. So Exlord right now has the hero advantage. I think his unit mix is looking really strong here against what his opponent has to offer. And let's see, he's actually, is he gonna try and defend? Like, this looks so scary to me. Okay, he's turning around. He doesn't dare to. But that, of course, isn't really helping him as well, because he's giving up one source of gold income. He's gonna have depleted this one in a couple of seconds. Seems like Exod hasn't scouted this so far. So, yeah, he's gonna be, yeah, a bit smarter in just a second when he's gonna see that there is this other expansion by Roll running. And actually that's the last source of gold income for Roll for now, but this one is gonna fall as well because there's just so much damage output for the Orc player. Actually losing one Windrider here. Yeah, there's just so much damage output and there is no Necropolis here. So this time Earthquake used a lot smarter, just to help him take down those towers and the Haunted Goldmine as quickly as possible. So this empty base is gonna be killed as well, but that's nothing Roll really cares about at this point. So he's gonna be gladly trading an empty base against this expansion. This one should be empty as well. So both the players having one expansion running right now. He's actually TPing down here very early on. So he just wants to make sure he can position himself. Because of course if the TP comes unfortunate and all the Windriders get webbed, then he's basically screwed immediately. So I feel like Exlord's army really looks stronger here. But with the four towers to support him, Roll might be able to hold on to this expansion at least for now. And these Acolytes, is he gonna expand here? It looks like he's gonna try and expand here at the top. I feel like this one would be the more obvious choice, but yeah, maybe the obvious choice is not really the best in this case, and Death Knight is gonna be forced to TP here, being just a little bit overly aggressive. Looks like two ghouls have gone down in his TP as well, so a little victory here for Roll. Also, Exlord, yeah, making a little bit of a mistake, wasting 150 gold here, using the heal potion before his TP, which was completely useless. The X-Lord, yeah, he's also at 87 supply by now. And there is the expansion for him. Of course, X-Lord is more under pressure to continue his expanding process than his opponent is, because this one still has more than 10,000, whereas this one is gonna run out in 1,000 more gold. Oh, and he's just going to the shop. Does he see it? Oh, that's horrible. He's gonna have to TP. Like, this is the worst position he can just imagine. Yeah, there's the TP on the TC chest board. And yeah, he's using that. I'm wondering why didn't he use Stomp here before, but he should have definitely not positioned his entire army here. There was no space to micro at all. And oh, he actually, it seems like he just double clicked and went to the top, so that's gonna leave his expansion exposed for a little while. And if Xlord takes the opportunity, that's just awesome for him.
Our town is under
there is
attack.
Yeah, there's barely the gold for another TP on the shop if he wants, but he's gonna lose all the towers. So even if he TPs in, I feel like he's not gonna be able to win this fight anymore.
Summoning.
So what's he doing? He's not gonna try and defend here. Looks like he's going to the bottom right corner. So yeah, roll out of gold income. Still has a huge load of Windriders though. But he might be thinking, I'm not sure when he scouted here the last time, but he might be thinking that Xlord is gonna run out of gold income in a couple of seconds as well. So he might feel more comfortable than he should right now, since Xlord obviously has this expansion running and yeah, just continuously securing his gold advantage. So yeah, Xlord just feeling the consequences of this game on his health. Of course, this is going on for more than 50 minutes right now in pretty high tension for most of the game, at least after the early game in which both the players just crept like the entire map. So I'm curious if he's gonna try and defend here. I mean, does he really have a choice? It seems like he's not gonna try and defend. But this means he's gonna lose every building he's got remaining on the land. And he's just yeah, bringing his entire army, so it looks like he might be going for another island. But if he loses his beastries, then he's not going to be able to reproduce anything for an insanely long amount of time. And also the Dreadlord is getting closer and closer to level 10, so actually the Carrion Swarm is gonna be really useful against those Windriders as well. And he's building another expansion at the bottom. So yeah, there's that expansion coming, and he did add two attack upgrades in the meantime, didn't see that earlier. So that's definitely not the worst choice. Also, Stone Token might be a huge help in maybe taking down the Death Knight with a Stomp Bolt combination if it's well timed. And there's the level 10 on the Death Knight. Still no upgrades on his Fiends, but the Abominations and the Ghouls are just really, really benefiting from those upgrades right now. So let's see if he's gonna... Oh, maybe he's gonna reveal? Yeah, there is the reveal. That is, of course... Yeah, he's just revealing all the islands. Okay, not this one.
Our town is under attack.
So yeah, Roll doing some more damage with those Windriders. I mean, Xlord has towers all over the map, so he doesn't really care about these Ziggurats. And right now the entire army is coming in. I mean, it's gonna be really difficult for Xlord to really get on this island here if Roll pays attention, because he's gonna be able to take down any Zeppelins with one wave of Windrider shots. So it looks like he's gonna somehow have to work from up here. That's nice, throwing the coil and then just neglecting it with his own sleep. Look at the mana on this Dreadlord, 900 almost. And doing the same thing again, so some awesome timing here by X-Lord. So is he gonna get this Farseer out? Using the Carrion Swarm as well. Taking quite some damage, but let's just see. He's got no gold. He cannot even build a shop right now. So every bit of damage he's taking is really, really hurting him. And it looks like at this point Roll might just be dragging out the game. I mean, he's gonna secure the source of gold income, which is of course nice. But there's a long way to go if he really wants to make a comeback here. Okay, there's the reveal, so he right now noticed that there are no Wind Riders here. Getting the Zapper, which is completely useless. So I'm wondering, did X-Lord just learn about that right now? That you cannot put a Zapper into a Zeppelin? Like, if that was the case, that would be so strange. Okay, it doesn't go for the Zeppelin. That's kind of strange. Okay, I'm assuming he expects a Fiend in there. And he doesn't want to get a Wind Rider wept. Yeah, that is a nice combination. Coil, Carrion, Swarm, and it's just doing a lot of damage on this Raider. So let's just take a look here. There's still 2,500 in this gold mine. This one, of course, with 8,500 still running as well. And the Wind Riders, what's he doing with those? I mean, if he just sits around with them, he's definitely not going to come out on top here. And X-Lord actually starts killing his own ghouls. It looks like he wants to boost his gold income here just by a little bit and get back into high upkeep, low upkeep. I need to kill one more. Maybe he just exploded a Zapper somewhere. So there is gold income again, but he cannot even rebuild peons, while all that time his opponent has two mines running. The vision is also quite interesting here for these heroes, just seeing a little bit over the forest, doing as much damage as they can. This is kind of sad, like I didn't remember this game dragging on for so long. Especially after the first 50 minutes, which were kind of insane, with a lot of great fighting. Our forces are under attack. So he can take down the Zeppelin, but the Raider goes down, his only Raider. And that's gonna remain his only Raider for a very long time, so he's maybe not even gonna get... Okay, yeah, he does get the Zeppelin killed. And the Kodo is gonna fall as well. So two more very crucial kills, and there's only the two heroes left at the island right now. It seems like X-Lord is not aware of the fact that these Wind Riders are not sitting around the base anymore, at least right now. If he was aware of it, he could just get a Zeppelin and drop here with everything immediately. Okay, that's actually a bit unfortunate for X-Lord. So he's gonna lose all the acolytes here. This one only has 1,000 gold remaining.
Our pound is under attack. Upgrade complete. Upgrade
complete. And actually, I feel like this could become a bit of a threat. I mean, there is still the chance that X-Lord drops here and loses a fight. So he definitely wants to have some kind of an economic backup. And yeah, the towers have gone down and he's gonna have to defend this right now, I feel like. He could go all in right now and risk allowing his opponent to get back into the game. I mean, it's a long shot. It's a very long shot for Roll. But he actually is defending. And now this orb, which he found like 45 minutes ago down here, is proving very, very useful for him. So he does not dare going in here. Also nicely placed sentry ward by Roll, allowing him to see whenever a drop is going to occur. And the Death Knight is gonna have to wait here until those towers are up and ready to defend this expansion. In the meantime, this one is about to run out as well. But yeah, the damage output of those guys is just amazing. Maybe he could even go for the Death Knight here right now. Looks like he doesn't dare to.
Our gold mine has collapsed.
Been adding a third crypt. So I'm assuming since Roll is tier 1, Gargoyles would be a great choice against those Windriders. So he just continues taking down Acolyte after Acolyte, even getting level 8 on his Farseer by now. So finally the lack of dust of appearance is not going to be that big of a deal anymore. But that was obviously one of the points that really, really made this game unnecessarily hard for Roll, who had a huge economic lead for a really long time here. And I think it's kind of unfortunate that the game shifted into Xlot's favor the way it did. Like, if you remember, there was the expansion here for Roll, which was decently towered with 4 towers, and Xlot had the slightly superior army plus superior heroes. So he sees that this is empty as well. So only the one source of gold income, which is more or less running stable for Xlot. And when this expansion was still up for Roll, there was the creep check up here, and he TP'd to the top and left this expansion completely exposed. So just by choosing his position of TP wrong, he kinda just completely gave the advantage to Xlot. So it wasn't like Xlot was winning a deciding fight or anything. It was just kind of a strange anticlimactic way to really give away the advantage in this game. So with only the Infernal, he's already putting those two heroes that's funny with all he's already putting those two heroes into a bit of trouble. I mean, especially the Farseer, obviously, who's not going to come back after dying, is threatened very much by this. Just see where the Windriders flying around the top, but this expansion is going to be secured soon. I mean, he lost a couple of Windriders, and with this number of Windriders, he's not gonna wanna fight against finished towers plus the level 8 Death Knight. I don't really see that happening. Our forces are under attack. Does he get perch? No, he doesn't get perch on this destroyer. So, Xlord. I mean, he really, really suffered from this harassment. It's like, it's very strange that this game is still not 100% over. Because technically, I mean, in any straight up fight, Xlot would just crush Roll right now. But the fact that he still needs to get on this island and finish him is kind of keeping Roll in the game. And Xlot still hasn't really been able to save up a lot of gold. That was kind of a mistake. But not punished by a coil.
Work complete.
And Xlot just seems to not be sure enough. Okay, now maybe. Was about to say he seems to not be sure enough to risk going on the island without an economic advantage. Oh, and that is very expensive. He's going for this round on the Farseer, and actually, does he cancel it? Maybe if he cancels it, he could get out. No, he doesn't. and he's got the fast here, so another chain lightning. He's doing so much damage against the Goose, but Heat Wave helping him out here at least for now. He scrolls, sorry. And is the TC gonna be the next target? He does have the invo potion, so this TC, that's a bad idea, I think. DK has to use the invo potion here, and against this double stun, he's using his TP very early on. And he brought back his Windriders. So this expansion is finally, finally secure. And I feel like right now is definitely the time. He does have 5 fiends, couple of ghouls, couple of illuminations. He definitely saw that one. So that's not gonna surprise him. Yeah, right now I feel like it's the time, especially with the Farseer gone. He already is rebuilding the altar, but it's gonna take a very, very long time until his Farseer is back. doing the same move again. So yeah, Altar is finished and now he starts Gargoyle production. But I feel like the number of Windriders has dropped enough to just allow X-Lord to win this fight rather convincingly with his fiends. So that's a bit of a mistake here by X-Lord, losing the destroyer, giving a bit more experience to the TC, but that one is very far off level 9. And now it looks like he feels comfortable enough to again go for the island here. And Roll is trying to punish that immediately. The Zeppelin once again gets taken out. He doesn't dare going away from his fiends here with the ghouls, because all of them will just get focus fired down by the Windrider so quickly. And the Rock Golem with his last move waking up the TC once again. But at least this buys Roll a bit of time to get his Farseer back. And surprisingly enough, like, this is so strange, X-Lord has been in such a huge advantage for like 15 minutes right now, and yet he's only up by 18 supply. And I'm guessing he's gonna buy the Zeppelin here right now, because the one on this laboratory probably has cooldown. That might be a tiny bit too late. So yeah, the Farseer will be back for the upcoming fight. There's gonna be 80 supply, undead army, plus an infernal, obviously, level 10 dreadlord, level 9 death knight. Couple of gargoyles against these Windriders. Quite some burrows, but he only has 5 peons at this point. Also, finally, Windrider production starts again. So actually, it's one base against one base, and or is he? No, he's not. So it's one base against one base. Actually, the orc base is gonna run for a longer time. So if he holds this, he's actually not in too bad of a position. But that's a big if, and that's a big undead army. So shop actually finishes. but completely out of position, and that one is just gonna die immediately. Mana potion available on both the Orc heroes though. So first shock, chain lightning is going in here, and actually the gargoyles are all getting annihilated immediately. Infernal used against the Farseer. The Farseer still has the Invo potion, so that's gonna save him for a while. Dreadlord is the target here. If the level 10 Dreadlord would fall, that would of course be very, very bad for the Undead player. But right now, Fuchs Fire was switched away for just a second. Ultimate used by the Death Knight once again as well. Farseer has fallen right now, so yeah, it's only the TC and a couple of Wind Riders, but those are being webbed and killed one by one right now. As you can see, only three Wind Riders are remaining. Another stomp by the TC, but it's only the TC left, and that one isn't going to be able to beat the entire Undead army by himself. It's 10 supply against 61, so even though he secured this expansion, and even though his expansion had more gold inside it than the one of Exord, in the end he wasn't able to pull through here anymore. So after an hour and 10 minutes, finally Exlord secures the win here. As I mentioned, I feel like in the end the game dragged on for a little bit too long. I feel like there were a couple of key points throughout this game. I mean, in the early game there was a lot of creeping with Exlord coming out with the better hero levels. Then there was the first push against a Rolls main, where Exlord lost his Death Knight with the TP in a fight which went otherwise really, really good for him, which with his Death Knight he would probably have been able to break these three towers and maybe even secure the victory after 20 minutes. But then again, that led to a very high level Dreadlord very early on. And yeah, afterwards it was just straight up both players battling it out with Raiders, Wind Riders against Ghouls, Fiend mix. And as I pointed out, it's kind of sad to me how Exlord got so far ahead after like 50 minutes by just having a horribly chosen TP by Rolls, giving Exlord the opportunity to take down Rolls' last expansion for free, basically, and giving him a huge edge. And I was pretty surprised actually by, I mean, it wasn't really close in the end. The end fight was really, really one-sided. But as to how close Roll still got in the end, I mean, if he somehow had held that, it would have actually looked good for him. Even though he was just sitting on the island for like more than 15 minutes. And yeah, so there was actually a reason for dragging this game out. Then again, maybe Exlord was too cautious in trying to secure his expansion first and giving his opponent time to get to tier 2 again, get beast trees up again, etc. So maybe he should have just gone for the all-in earlier on, but of course there's always the risk of getting a Zeppelin killed, etc. And if he did that, and then if he lost that Zeppelin, or if he lost the game because of that, everyone would have said how stupid and overly greedy, and how he was just not patient enough. So in the end, Exlord did it right here, won the game. Obviously he didn't even get close to winning the Inn Cup, and that is it. I hope once again you enjoyed. As always, give a thumbs up, give a comment, and I see you. Bye.